What if I told each and every one of you that there could be a Call of Duty open world game in the future? Open world RPG, open world sandbox. What would you think about that? Now, this topic could go either way, but it does beg at least the conversation to happen, which is what we're going to do today. And these leaks just came out. Now, you could call them a leak. Well, yeah, you can call it a leak because it was deleted, which kind of confirms that it wasn't supposed to be out there. We're going to talk about the possibility of the Call of Duty franchise going to an open world status. Now, we're going to look at both sides of this. So just calm down if you're getting excited or you're getting upset, because there's a lot to unpack here. Do me a favor, guys. Make sure you're subscribed. And let's just jump right into this. Now, Charlie Intel tweeted this out a couple minutes ago. A job description on Infinity Ward's site, IW site, says Activision is looking for a narrative director for Infinity Ward's pull-in office to work on an unannounced open-world RPG title. You heard me right. An unannounced open-world RPG title. So the first thing you think is Call of Duty's making an RPG. Well, it's not that simple. It could be the fact that Activision is going to have Infinity Ward step out of their comfort zone and start new projects that don't have anything to do with Call of Duty. But then again, that wouldn't make a lot of sense because Infinity Ward's one of the primary three studios for Call of Duty. And we are about to get into COD 2.0, which is a fresh take on COD and basically a whole new scene when it comes to Call of Duty. They've embraced this themselves, that they're kind of rebooting, and we're going into COD 2.0. So it's not up anymore. It was deleted, okay? Which is why I said, well, that's the confirmation of a leak when they put something up and then they delete it. And other people said, well, they may have just hired somebody. Well, okay. So it said, Activision Publishing is seeking a talented, passionate narrative director to create and direct the implementation of story, dialogues, and scenes for an unannounced AAA project. In this role, you will create a cohesive vision for the narrative presentation, its connection with the gameplay experience, and you will be responsible for direction of cinematic moments. Before we read anything else, guys, gameplay experience. Do me a favor. Go check out Chaos 4K. It is our new gameplay channel. We are giving away copies of Modern Warfare 2, the Vault Edition. All you have to do is be subscribed and leave a comment on any video. You will be entered. I'm giving it away to three people, and I will announce those three winners on the community tab of Chaos 4K. If you like 4K high quality HDR gameplay, get over there and subscribe. Now, let's keep going. The ideal candidate will have proven experience working on non-linear narratives in open world games and directing cinematics in AAA quality. Non-linear, that means not on the rails. Think back to how video games have been for a long time. When I say on the rails, it's like you're on a train, right? And that train and that track and those rails are taking you along your mission. You don't get to go off the path, if you will. That's linear. Non-linear means we can go wherever we want. Think The Witcher 3. We can explore whatever we want. Think Skyrim, things like that. Okay, responsibilities. Partner with the game director and team leadership to set the overall vision and direction for an unannounced AAA project. Your role is to provide the best narrative and cinematic experience in an open world RPG. Not an open world FPS. Not an open world third-person shooter. Not an open world turn-based strategy game. Open world RPG. Role-playing game. Participate in creation of the game story, characters, lore, and the world building. So, it said it right there explicitly. Now, that doesn't mean that it's a Call of Duty game, but then again, you're talking about Infinity Ward's job description for their pull-in office, and all Infinity Ward really does is Call of Duty. I mean, even Charlie Intel said themselves, it's not clear if it's a new IP or within the Call of Duty world. I saw people suggesting this could be the DMZ mode. I don't think so at all. I think this is something brand new that has nothing to do with what we're covering with Modern Warfare 2 or DMZ, but then there was the posting about Warzone and the Next Generation, and at the very bottom, you guys can see it on the screen here. In addition, expect more intel on a new sandbox mode in the brand new play space as we get closer to launch. They did say we would be getting some kind of sandbox mode with Warzone 2 in a brand new play space. Now, I don't know if this is going to be a map editor, which we talked about in the past, which could actually be happening. A lot of prominent insider sources are saying this is going to happen. I don't know if this is DMZ. I don't know if this is some kind of story mode that's going to come along with Warzone 2 in some open sandbox. Because when you say new sandbox mode, brand new play space, the first thing I think of is like Fortnite, where you can go create stuff, right? Sandbox means massive, means huge, means non-linear, which kind of goes with the job posting. Brand new play space means you can play around, not necessarily, I'm on a story RPG style, but I can play around. Maybe I can edit this map. Maybe I can add bots over here. Maybe I can add mountains over here. So it could have something to do with that. But if you go back to the job listing, it really, really sounds like this is the beginning of an IP, which kind of excites me because, look, either way, I feel like this is a win. If we are going to stick with this one-year off, one-year on cycle that we are with Call of Duty, 2023 doesn't have a major title. We know that. Now, we're going to get Call of Duty offerings. Warzone 2 is going to be out. Warzone Mobile, they've already confirmed that's coming. We'll probably get some remaster next year to fill the gaps. They're not going to not do Call of Duty. We're just not getting the new, fresh AAA title. So if that's how we're going to move forward, this would be really cool. I mean, on one hand, I would like to see what Infinity Ward could cook up outside of the Call of Duty space with an open world AAA RPG, but the selfish side of me says, give me a Call of Duty RPG, seriously. I mean, if it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out, but if it does, holy crap, that would be really, really cool to have a story-driven, non-linear, open sandbox RPG. I mean, you could literally connect all the stories from all the Call of Duty sub-franchises if you wanted to, or you go completely new. I mean, could you imagine if we had stories connected from modern type COD games, from past, from future space, like Black Ops 3 and Infinite Warfare and Advanced Warfare? It could get wild. I know it could get convoluted and kind of messy as well, but it could definitely get wild. So, this is all we have to go off right now. But there was a job posting on Infinity Ward's website for an open world RPG person, a narrative director, to be able to help provide the best narrative and cinematic experience for a new open world RPG. Characters, lore, world building. I think Warcraft, Call of Duty Warcraft. That's where we're heading with this. I don't know. Give me your best thoughts. Do you think it has anything to do with Call of Duty, or do you think it's a brand new IP? And if it's a brand new IP, is that a good idea for Infinity Ward to branch off and start other stuff when they are a primary developer for the Call of Duty franchise? I really want you guys' opinions. Make sure you check out Chaos 4K, guys. Thank you for all the love you've been showing on the channel. I told you guys, it's all Modern Warfare 2, Call of Duty, and Warzone 2 on this channel. We are covering absolutely everything for you guys. We're dug in. And we're getting it done. I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you soon.